So the term that was used in boxers, it was really began in the 1928 as punch drunk, but then very quickly was called the dementia pugilistica of boxers. It had other names. Over the years, people called it post-traumatic encephalopathy, and then even in the 40s and 50s, 1950s, people were talking about it as chronic traumatic encephalopathy. The idea that was that the disease was not just restricted to boxers. It could be from brain trauma of many causes. And so I think they felt that the chronic traumatic encephalopathy was slightly more broad and could represent that. And when you looked at the literature after I'd seen Paul Pender's brain, yes, some people called it dementia pugilistica and some people called it chronic traumatic encephalopathy. They're, in my mind, indistinguishable. They have the same criteria of diagnosis, the same patterns of change. The original studies were done using silver stains, which is a stain that's been around for over 100 years. It was, you know, it was how we originally diagnosed Alzheimer's disease, like in the 1900s. But as science has advanced, our techniques have advanced, and it was really in the 1980s that immunocytochemistry, or the ability to use an antibody to tag a protein and then color it, became widely used. And so the original studies on dementia pugilistica were only silver studies, silver stain studies, and that does not show the changes nearly as well as tau immunocytochemistry. So that was the thing that changed in the 90s, really. People started looking at boxers and individuals with this CTE with tau, and they discovered a pattern of abnormalities that had never been described before.
This video was produced by BrainLine, thanks to generous support from the Infinite Hero Foundation.